cannon carts are super powerful right now and making for some explosive endings. Welcome back, fellow fans of Clash of Clans, or if it is your first time here, thank you guys so much for stopping by. That's right, this is a live cannon cart attack. It's happening right now, or it happened right then. It's happening now. Anyway, that's not cannon carts. Hold on. So this is one of the many bases that we're seeing the cannon carts absolutely destroy. These diamond bases, also the square bases. There are players in Night Mode Clash that are attacking any base with this exact army composition. Two camps of giants and two camps of cannon carts. Now, a lot of players are going with two entry points into a base like this. I just went with one, using the battle machine to make sure, or at least hoping, that most of the spring traps in the area were triggered, and then the cannons in behind. As you can see, the cannons kind of splitting up here. We've got one that's kind of going rogue off to the left. We want to make sure that the giants and the battle machine are tanking the big defenses. It didn't work right here, as we lose two cannon carts to a single double cannon, but it's not going to matter. Check it out, as we've got two remaining cannon carts, a few giants in the center, and the battle machine not getting damaged by that first crusher, and that is going to make a huge difference right here. We've got lots of tanks to keep those last two cannon carts up. As you can see, we finally are going to lose the last giant, but the battle machine is at full health, and he is going to lead the way for both of these cannon carts, for one of these cannon carts, as one goes down. But that's all we need. As you can see, one cannon cart, one battle machine with his ability up one more time is going to be plenty to get through Crazy Turk's base. If you noticed, he was watching, but he couldn't bear to witness the total destruction of his village. Looks like the cannon and the battle machine are going to make it through to the end. Then the cannon, unfortunately, gets sprung off the base, but the battle machine is able to do it, picking up a 3-star with 6 giants and 4 cannon carts. Now, of course, if you guys watched the other day's episode where I did the Q&A with the Clash of Clans team, you'll remember that they don't want to see too many 3-star wins, because if you start seeing 3-star ties, it kind of takes the fun out of the game a little bit. But right now, we are definitely seeing more 3-stars than we've seen in a long time by players using cannon carts and giants. Now, this is Superman from Night Mode Clash. He's another player in our clan that believes that you can take on just about any base with this same exact army composition. Look at those late giants moving in and passing the cannon carts. That is key right there. You've got fresh tanks moving in front of all 4 cannon carts still up. The builder hall goes down, just about to grab the 2nd star. And as you can probably imagine, these cannon carts are going to annihilate this base. Only one giant remains, but also only 2 defenses. And quickly, the last 3 cannon carts are focused on them, and there you go. It is all over. Nothing left but just a matter of getting through these without losing the giant or the cannons to spring traps, giant mines. Sure enough, as we get towards the end, what looks like a certain 3-star victory is about to be put into jeopardy. Oh my goodness! You lose everybody except for one cannon cart in the last stand ability. Let's go back and take a look at that one more time, as only 2 structures remain, the cannon carts, the giant. Trigger the spring traps, we lose 2 cannon carts, the giant goes down, another cannon cart, the last cannon cart hit by that mine, but it's got last stand, and that is all that's necessary. Somehow he's able to reach both remaining camps. Such a close call right here. Superman just barely, by the skin of his teeth, picking up the cannon cart giant 3-star win. Now, Superman, not the only player in our clan having a lot of success and some crazy endings with this same army composition. Let's watch Eric, also a global top builder base player. Here he is coming from the top of this open base at the bottom, kind of a diamond variant. This is a very popular base right now. And he is also, like you saw me earlier, going with the single entry right there. Very luckily, only loses 1 giant. He easily could have lost three right there. Just one giant goes. They get through the wall, everybody right on top of each other, but the multi-mortar is down, and that is the worst enemy of the carts right here, as now they're going to start to fall back. The giants are going to be slightly ahead, and that's going to avoid those carts getting splash damaged. The builder hall goes down for the first star. On the right-hand side, giant tanky for the carts. That's key, because the cart's not taking any damage whatsoever right here. And as you can see on the right-hand side, they're going to outrange everything but that one single cannon. The battle machine takes out the double cannon, and now, suddenly, there's only one defense. There's no defenses that can stop the cannon carts. And again, we're looking at simply a matter of time and avoiding traps. We speed things up. The cannon cart's doing a great job. And again, it looks like they're just going to have an overwhelming victory. Double giant mines almost took out all of the cannon carts, but again, Eric picks up the three-star win. We're going to go back one more time and check out what happened right at the very end right there. As you can see, the cannons converging on the gem mine, and there you go. Awful lot of explosive power puts three carts down at the same time. But again, the far left cart is in last stand. He's got the range, one cart at the top, and that's all Eric needed to grab another three-star victory. All right, here is Barbarian King 12, also from Night Mode Clash, also using the giants and the cannon carts against a very similar base. You can see the opening on the right-hand side, and check out this strategy, you guys. I love this. One giant at the top of your screen is going to distract the multi-mortar. He's out of range of every other defense, so he's only going to be taking damage from the multi-mortar. That lets him live a long time while everybody else does the dirty work on the right-hand side of your screen. The battle machine is down. Just a couple of giants. Okay, no giants left in the center. The one giant on the wall is there, and he is going to become key in just a few seconds. As the cannon carts start to fall, you've lost two of them at the top. The two at the bottom are still there. The giant is finally going to get through that wall right as these cannon carts are approaching the multi-mortar and that last archer tower. The archer tower, the only thing that could stop this attack. Right here, the cannon cart goes into last stand within range of both defenses. The multi-mortar goes down, and now it's just a giant against everybody. So make your guesses right here, guys. What do you think is going to happen? 80%, is it, where is it going to stop? How far can he get? Can he get a 3-star? 90%, 82%, well, 83. Let me know what you think. Here we go. Just a matter of time, a minute 30 on the clock. We will speed things up as it's a giant versus these final half dozen structures. He's working on that clock tower. So many hit points. Gets through it. 86. Did you guess higher than 86? Did you guess 3 stars? Let me think. I'm guessing a lot of you guessed 3 stars. Well, time is running down. High hit point structure here. Then a couple of lower ones. Getting right down to the last structure. Can't get it done. And Barb King ends up with a 98% 2-star. All right, you guys. A couple of questions I wanted to answer real quick. This one right here, Ultra, says, if I'm a Builder Hall 4 and I'm matching up against 6s, am I better than them? I would say most likely yes, you are, if they're in your trophy range. Adam says, Itsu doesn't battle, he just allows you to lose. Kind of building on the Chuck Norris joke there. But remember, Itsu is human. He doesn't win every single battle. Nobody does. And that's the beauty of this game. Right here, Zvonko wants to know, where is Cam? Clash with Cam, trust me. I made sure he was there with me during my last trip with Supercell. You'll see that very, very soon. Daniel says, I tried your deck and it sucks. That's a Clash Royale video, but remember, Daniel, there are no bad decks, only bad players. Well, more or less. All right, moving on. Right here, Nate Dog says, there needs to be a 2v2 TV Royale also. I sort of agree, but just about every 2v2 battle is a lot of fun unless your opponent leaves. R. John wants to know about Brawl Stars. I am going to be posting more Brawl Stars content. I just want it to go global first so that everybody can enjoy it. And then Jones, talking about quests and Royale, says, yeah, this might bring me back to the game. And I love this one. Gabriel says, this new update, also referring to Royale, will make me re-uninstall the game. Well, we'll see. Thank you guys, as always, for watching all the way to the end of this episode. Make sure you hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications. I am giving out gift cards in almost every single Mixer.com stream. It's at the top right there. Have a fantastic day. You are the Gallo fam. I love every one of you, and I hope to see you all again tomorrow for more Full Attacks.